Hey fellow Vault Dwellers, it's Angry Tartul, and today I have for you my list of the best commander weapons for every occasion. And I have 8 different categories, although there is less than 8 different weapons, because some of those weapons are so good that win more than one category. And a quick disclaimer here, I never include any legacy weapons in my ranking. Only weapons actually available in the game are in my rankings. And now, without further ado, let's jump straight in. First, for the category Silent Boss Killer, we have the Fixer, and preferably quad for the prefix. About the second and third star, your perfect will be 50% crit damage, 25% less AP cost. Although, quad is the important fact. As long as it's quad, you'll be doing just fine. Here are the modifications that I'd recommend for the weapon. And now let's kill a couple enemies with this weapon. You will see it's really good everywhere. And to let you know, no, I will not be killing bosses. And the reason for that is it's way too slow. If I would go and try to demonstrate every weapon on the bosses that I rank high for boss fights, yeah, this video will be much longer than intended. Therefore, that's the Fixer. And second category, we have boss fights, but unsuppressed weapon. The loud variety of automatic weapons. And here the winner is Quad Railway Rifle. This weapon have insane damage per shot. It's not silent, but damage per shot are insane. The downside of this weapon is low mag capacity. That's nicely fixed with quad, and other legendary effects will be the same recommended. Crit damage, less AP cost, recommended modifications on the right. And this weapon is incredibly powerful regardless where you use it. Like you can see on those super mutants, they die in one shot or two. That's a beast. And usually, like, even though I'm sneaking, that's only because they die so fast, they have no chance to actually detect me. But this weapon is very loud. Category number 3. The most universal weapon, optionally your secondary weapon, as it's using different ammo, 5.56. But why is it my choice, the most universal? As handmade can fulfill basically any role. If you will get good roll for boss fights like quad crit damage, it will be perfect for bosses. If you will get something like bloodied VATS hit chance, it's perfect for everyday use in VATS and outside of VATS, as recoil on this weapon is not too bad. Surprisingly useful everywhere and not much far behind the winners in other categories. Now, as you can see in practice, like, there is no visible difference. It's doing basically the same job as the Fixer and everything else. There is a difference, but it's small enough that as long as you are not going to, like, maximize your DPS output on the bosses, it does not matter. And if you want to shoot it without VATS, as you can see, control is good even when not sneaking, not using the VATS, just running around. It's working. That's why it's universal. You can hip fire. You can aim down the sight. You can do whatever you want. Like, handmade can fulfill every single role in commando build. And as I'm talking about the handmade, my next category with the same winner is the best hip fire suppressed weapon. And here I have handmade again. It is a suppressed weapon, and as you can see, hip fire is super stable compared to any other option. Like, Fixer cannot do that, other weapons cannot do that, or some of the other weapons that can do that cannot dish out so much damage. Therefore, handmade suppressed hipfire weapon winner, no VATS. And next category, the best VATS suppressed weapon. And back to the Fixer. It's not only best for the bosses, it's best for every situation, for VATS build, when you want suppressed weapon. The best damage of all, really low cost in VATS. It's perfect. There is no better weapon for VATS, regardless actually even of legendary rolls. For everyday use, You can go with non-legendary and will do perfectly fine. And recommended modifications, the same as I showed before for the boss fights. Next category, the best weapon for hip fire action without a suppressor. And here my winner is automatic laser rifle. Very steady with current mechanic involving the splitter and tenderizer. Insanely good damage. Therefore, that's my clear winner. And for the recommended legendary effects, quad or vampire as a prefix. For the second star, damage while aiming or faster fire rate. And for the third star, possibly more durability. Recommended modifications as always on the right. And now quick demonstration for the weapon. It's super steady. You will not lose your aim. It's not going up and down while firing. It's ideal for the scenario when you actually need to hip fire it. Assuming you are tanky, as this weapon is loud. That's an option when you jump in your power armor and you are not worried about dying. Unless it's a vampire, then healing will be so crazy that you don't need to worry regardless. And it's quite satisfying to use. Next category, best for VATS without a suppressor. Overall, again, railway rifle. And this time the main reason for that is railway rifle naturally have very low AP cost, which means you can use it in power armor and you will not run out of your AP. And as you know, in power armor, you don't have as much AP as in like an unyielding set of armor. But in case of railway, even if there is no less AP cost on third star, you are still perfectly fine. And recommended legendary rolls, it will be for the first star, quad. Railway actually do not work very well with anything else than quad. For the second star, it can be VATS hit chance if you want to use it on daily basis. And for the third star, less AP cost. And finally, the last category, the weapon for area effect or tagging enemies. And here, of course, we have Tesla. The best legendary effects, vampire or quad. For the second star, damage while aiming or faster fire rate. For the third star, there is no specific requirements. If you'll be using this weapon on the events, of course, like a short burst is recommended. It does work with Grenadier, therefore, yep, the range of those electric arcs is really good. The vampire effect will keep you alive no matter what, as of course this weapon is not suppressed and there is no good suppressed weapon for area of effect. In case you are not doing any type of events, aiming directly at enemy actually do more damage than the arc. As you can see, I killed this one guy and other guys lose some health but did not die just from arcs, and unfortunately I wasn't paying enough attention to my health and somehow they managed to kill me. I'm here to finish them off. Bye, super mutants. Yep, both melted. Oh, this one hiding. As you can see, that's not the most powerful weapon. Therefore, using it for anything else than area of effect damage or events is not recommended. And if you really need damage, you need quad. Vampire is only good on events if you want to survive or if you can handle quite frequent reloads. Like this one legendary super mutant, if I want to kill him, maybe if I do it in VATS, I can kill him. Yes, in VATS, I can kill him. But this other guy only lost like half of his health. This is not the best weapon for VATS. He's dead. Like, this weapon is doing damage. Definitely not the best damage, though. I can get even this guy hiding over there. And that will be my list of best automatic weapons you can find in Fallout 76 for every occasion. And there was only 5 weapons in total, even though there was 8 categories. And those 5 weapons are handmade, railway rifle, laser rifle, fixer, and Tesla rifle. Those are my winners. And as always, please share with me, what are your favorite automatic commander weapons that you can find in Fallout 76? Do you have one favorite that you use all the time? Or are you swapping between two or three different weapon types? Let me know in the comment section. And that will conclude this video. Thank you a lot for watching, and see you all in the next one.